Hello, welcome back. Last time I finally finished the cemetery dungeon and got back to the surface. I don't think I need these anymore. I also just played for about 10 minutes without actually pressing the record button. But you know what, that's okay, I accomplished basically nothing. So maybe I'll do it better this time. So I have a huge amount of just junk everywhere to sort out. I didn't want to deal with it. So you know what, let's do this differently. I'm going to take all of the things, instead of piling them all up there, I'm going to sell everything that can be sold first. Just to get it out of here. To cast the most powerful paladin spell, you need to wear a complete torchbearer armor set. Oh, okay. Interesting. Okay, so can't resurrect until I get a specific set of gear. Alright. Here, have a lot of ancient helms. Let's see, this is protection plus 5. I don't think I need to keep those around. That's plus 4. You have, well, you have that. But nobody has ancient armor proficiency. That probably won't happen anytime soon. I'm gonna keep this, though. That's light armor. Right, so if I want to make him survive longer but not hit quite as hard, I could do that. Skull Cleave is a heavy weapon. You know how to use heavy weapons, but this is better. Bone Club, I don't think I can sell, but I'll try. Flare Feather Cap. Nobody wants that, right? Well, you know, it's better for you if I give you another point at firearms, so maybe. Right, you lose the evasion, but that gives you energy. You don't really need evasion anyway. I have a lot of torches here. I don't know that I'm going to use them, but I guess I'll keep them with me in this bag, maybe? Sure, why not? What's in this bag? Herbs and things. And rum for some reason. I don't know what the rum does, actually. I should try it at some point, just so I know. This should go somewhere. I think I can sell peasant's breeches. Probably. Keeping peasant's breeches. Right, can't do that again for another 5 minutes. I need to remember to do that frequently. Somebody said to read the description of this more closely. I read it, and I don't see what's so special about it. This magical item is used by wizards to catch the energy of ghosts and spirits that roam the realms. So I don't know if that somehow has to do with, like, the ghosts that I saw down there in the graveyard or something. Well, I don't know, but I guess I'll keep it with me and see if I can find a use for it somewhere, somehow. Firewall, how's your capacity? It's okay, yours is okay, yours is good, yours is good, okay. Why do I have a bag that just has a rabbit's foot in it? Well, this stuff's going in my pile of gear. That bag's empty. Food is a thing that I need to worry about. Okay, but let me just sell. Sell. Okay. Okay. All of that gave me 1 silver, 3 copper. Cool. And he bought all of it, including the bone club. Okay, so it's just the bones on their own that can't be sold. If you're stuck, visit forum. Sure. Alright, so just want to drop off a few things so that I don't have to take them with me. Alright, so this box is going to be for this sort of thing. Crafting ingredients, etc. Trophies. Don't know exactly what I do with either of those things, really. Right, and I'm going to take these rings and have him identify them when he gets a chance. I don't know if the water flask is, I can use it. It's unclear what it would do. Like, this is another thing like the rum. Here, let me just do this. Let's find out what these things do. So I'm going to quick save. Drink both and see if I can observe an effect. Oh! Well, I should have done that a long time ago. Does that... No, it says temporary effect. Okay, so temporarily strength plus 1. So that's a short-lived increase of strength, okay? Water flask didn't appear to do anything at all. Okay. Well, I can drink it. I just found it somewhere. I'm figuring it might be a crafting ingredient or something sometime. Don't know what else I would do with a water flask, since there's no thirst in the game. Alright, so I could keep the rum around as a not very strong, but slight combat boost potion, because like 1 point in strength is not that much. I'm looking at a loading screen, by the way. Just so you know. Alright, water can go in there then, in here. Yeah, whatever, rum's there, mithril. Shield potion can stay on me, I guess. He can... Veltharion can actually cast shield. This goes here. Conwell Forest, sure. I have an ornate key, which I theorize might go in this keyhole here. That's the... perhaps the only ornate keyhole that I've seen. Maybe. I wanted to keep the rapier and the dagger and the shield because I like to have the option of dual wielding or giving him defense or, you know, he is acting kind of attached to his sword, so I guess I'll let him keep it. That potion, right, in case I decide you want protection instead of whatever. Flare feather cap, right, I was keeping it in case I wanted to replace that. 2 more minutes. You have all the torches. Crossbow quarrels. I'm not really sure where to put those. In here, I guess? Sure, why not? Okay, anything else anybody wants to ditch anywhere? This. This goes in the... there. This stays with me. That stays with me. All this stays with me. Okay. I think I'm good to go now. Sure. Well, I don't really need that many torches. Torches are, like, surprisingly heavy. So I'll just bring a few in case I want to use their light somewhere for some reason. Alright, good enough. That's basically sorted. So I think I'm gonna save. Go turn in this quest. And since I already did this once, I know where it sends me after that. So I go to the city hall, city rich quarter, whatever it's called, city council, that's it. Go talk to Cornelius again. That's an interestingly colored lantern. Hmm. How do you get it to burn that color? Hey, wait a minute. Can I walk here? I can. Have I been here? No. This is new territory. Is there anything here? Yes, kinda. Oh, money. Okay, found some street money. All right, city council. You have met Cornelius and explained him what happened on the cemetery. Mummy Lord, you say? As not enough troubles, it is already 2 days we did not receive any news from the East Watchtower. I need to ask you go there and check what happened. I will instruct guards to let you pass through trough the gates. Here, take this reward as for your graveyard troubles. I will give you more when you return. Okay, great. He gives me 1 gold. And a new quest scroll. Hey, wait, I still have this on me. I meant to ditch that back there. Now, this one I don't need anymore, so you can just keep it. Well, I guess I'll put it in my pile of stuff. I have 3 empty bags here. One of them should be filled with food. People are not starving yet, but I will need to feed them. All right, so East Watchtower. Fortunately, I marked those on my map, so I know exactly where to go. Alright, I want to go and see Griff before I go there, but since I'm here, let's buy some stuff. So I can buy fortune cookie, bread, lizard steak, 1 copper, 2 copper, 3 copper. Bread sounds like maybe the best value? Maybe? I'm not actually sure. I found I can do this. Put a silver there, buy that. Do it again. Can I do it again? No, that's not enough. So enough for one for everybody. I'm probably going to need more than that because everybody's pretty much already hungry to the point where they need that. Except for Ratface here. He can wait a moment. Alright, so that's for you. So you know what? Why don't I just do that again? Here, let me just do it this way. 2 silver. Oh hey, I had a ruby briefly. Neat. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, great. So I have food to eat. If I'm jumping down any one-way pits anytime in the near future, I'll be sure to come back here and buy some more first, probably. Right, pile of stuff. Right, need to get complete Torchbearer armor set. Right, so if I want to resurrect, I need to be in full whatever armor. Alright, this stays here. This goes here. And I think I'm good. Okay. So let's go pay Griff a visit. Where's his shop? Over there. I should probably visit the other vendors and see if there's any gear I want to buy before I go anywhere. But I want to see what I'm up against first. Hi, Griff. Any news about the map? Actually, many interesting things. The map is not showing the position of the treasure itself. It only contains clues, hopefully leading to the treasure's location. Here, check it. The map is really old, though some details are recent. Other details are even older than I have seen in other maps, and trust me, I have seen many. Okay. Nevertheless, what is most important are the positions of the obelisks and its order. Obelisks, spelled with a K here, spelled with a C here, are old and ancient structures, maybe thousands of years old. Not much is known about them. Many wise men tried to discover their secrets and failed. It is clear that the obelisks contain the final clue as to where the treasure lies. Okay. I think you now have an opportunity to discover it. Take the map I made a copy. Visit all the obelisks, note its texts, and put them together. Meanwhile, I will try find out more. Okay. Great. Would that thing that I saw in, would this right here happen to be an obelisk? Force field was a dumb idea and doesn't seem to exist in this game anyway, so perhaps that's an obelisk? Let's see what this says. Whoa! Well, that's a map. Huh. Neat! Oh, that's an obelisk. Okay, so four... No, oh, there's a lot of them. Assuming those are the numbered things. No, wait, so this is... Okay, yeah, so there is one in that area. I think that's it. Yeah, it was right next to the shop. Okay, so that's obelisk number... That is really hard to read. I think that says 7? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, I guess. Eight, nine. Okay, so is this my quest in the world now? Visit those 9 locations and put their texts together? So this would be the Conwell Forest. I see there's another mountainous territory there. Giant sea serpent there. Can I visit him? A boat. This is where I came in. Some sort of fancy tower. Ah, this is on the other side of the outpost here, isn't it? Like, that's the river that I went in, explored a bunch, did a little bit of fishing, retrieved a bunch of stuff. Couldn't get over here because there were big fire elementals launching fire things into the water for me. Okay, so that's where the bridge is. This is the territory that was infested with ogres and city guards wouldn't let me go there. Maybe that's where I'm going next, possibly. 9 is over here in a desert or something. Okay. There's another town over here. Interesting. And snowy hills. Alright, well this was informative. Right. What if I put on your... Oh yeah, visit all the monoliths and note the code. Find the treasure. Okay. I should have a bag for this sort of stuff. since I have spare bags, let's do that. And you know what? I'll stick keys and lockpicks in here too. Okay, that seems orderly enough. While I'm here, I'm going to see a few things. Okay, so I don't believe that I have the spell I wanted. The spell I wanted was Lightning Bolt, this one. Advanced attack spell, air 4, cost 4 silver. Okay, so she's not actually at all close to that, is she? Oh no, she is. Air 3. Okay. Next level up, you could learn that. Okay, so I want to buy... Oops. What am I on? Lightning Bolt. Air 4 silver. That's pricey. But you know what? I definitely want it. I'm going to feel silly if I find this somewhere just out in the world. But I'm assuming I won't. So let's just do that. Alright, so you'll be ready to learn that. Hey, I'll bet I can do this again. Okay. It feels almost like a waste to level this up beyond 1. The thing is, though, with a 10-minute cooldown and several items that I want to identify, it's actually not. Because otherwise, if I just leave it at this level, I might not even get through my full queue of items to identify by the end of the game. So I do actually need to level up as Artifact Hunter more. Right, okay, so I bought Scroll of Lightning Bolt. I wanted to check through my pile of scrolls to see if there was anything else that Valtharion could learn, since he has some concentration. Let me just see what... like, he could learn the light... Well, but did I need to actually read the scroll for that? I'm not sure. In fact, did I need to buy this scroll at all? I don't know. I've done it now. I'm going to do some experimentation with that once she gets one more air magic to see if I could have just cast with the pattern instead of having to buy the scroll to see what it is. Because Valtharion was able to cast... Was it light? It wasn't light. Shield. He was able to cast shield without having read the shield scroll. So I think if I know the pattern, I might not even need to buy those. Maybe. I don't know for sure, though. Right. East Watchtower. Every time I visit this city, it seems like it just sucks up a huge amount of time. Takes a long time to do my business here. Right, East Watchtower. This one here. This one here. Not this one here. Are you talking about this, then? Probably. I guess that makes more sense. What was that quest? Investigate the watchtower east of the Conwyl and find out what happened there. Okay, well, I'm going east anyway, so I guess either their ogre troubles are over or... speaking of which, is there anything I want to buy here in ogre's armors? This stuff is all pretty expensive, but, like, I could afford it now. For one person. Nobody has heavy armor skill at the moment, so I could get Reed for 1 silver, Chitin for 3 silver, there's 9 protection. That's good stuff. So 3 silver per piece, 4 pieces. Pretty tempting, to be honest. Yeah, I should totally do that. Do I want to leave Valtharion lightly armored? Well, okay, so he can get Ascalon's hand-me-downs, if nothing else. Yeah, okay, sure. You know, here, let me actually make a hard save. Just in case, like, I absolutely need this money for something. But let me actually spend my money for once and buy some good stuff to help me out. Alright, so what am I on? Chitin Quis. Bye. Chitin Greaves. Bye. Chitin Mail. Bye. And then I should just be able to buy the other with what's on the table, chitin mask. Okay. And I still have 3 silver. Great. All right. So upgrade for you. Good. Your protection's up to 45 now. I didn't look at what it was before. How much of an upgrade was that? Oh yeah, that's more than double. Neat. Okay. So hopefully that was money well spent. So now for you, you get all his hand-me-downs. What's the... is there a set bonus for this? Do gloves exist? Okay, now this is just protection. Okay, well, just protection is good. You can get the extra energy because you are a spellcaster of sorts. So let's see, that's giving you one more protection. That's 3 plus 4. Oh wait, read leg mail. That's better. Unless I want the energy, which I might. +4, evasion +2, great. You'd lose a little bit of strength. You know what? I'm okay with that. I'll take the protection. Okay. That looks good enough to me. And I guess I want to just, like, put this stuff away. Certainly won't need this anymore. This is still kind of interesting, in case I want a bunch more strength. This is still kind of interesting. In fact, do I want to give that to you? Yeah, that's better than vitality. And you don't need the evasion, as far as I know. The thing is, with the situations that present themselves in this game, where I'm attacked from all angles, can't really go anywhere to dodge, back party members might actually need protection and evasion for stuff, so I do worry a little bit about doing things like that. So why don't I go ahead and just keep... what did I just give you? Those? Yeah, I'll keep those on you. I do need to ditch this stuff before I go anywhere because it's going to be too heavy, probably. I have some food. You can probably eat your bread now. Okay. And then I just wanted to put away some of this stuff. That's the wrong box. But this one is full of torches and things. Man. No, I didn't need the leather cap anymore. In fact, I could probably sell it. Because both of these are significantly better. Yeah, okay, so let's just sell the leather cap. Ugh, sorry for all the inventory management, but this is part of the game. It's gotta be done. You go here. Bag, some torches, sure, why not? I'm gonna sell the leather cap, then finally go to the watchtower. Because there's no way either of these are going to get light armor proficiency ever. So there's no reason I would keep this. Sell. Okay, great. Alright, watchtower. Watchtower in the east. Can't go this way. This is the wrong way. Where am I trying to go? Okay, so it's around this way. Okay. Just in case something happens, save. Okay. The Watchtower, that's the name of this place. Okay. That's not what I expected. I hear wargs. As you climbed up the hill, it is quite clear nothing good happened here. From the top of the tower is rising black smoke, and the bridge across the river is broken. Large pieces of debris are all around. Whatever happened here happened recently. Okay. Party of wargs. Watchtower smoking. All right. What spell do you cast? That one. Ah! I wasn't ready for you. I notice that his ammunition total is distinctly going downward. Oh hey, there's some food. Oh good, good. You give me food, that's very useful. Seems to be a finite resource though, so I should still be very conservative with it. So I'm wondering if, like, just for normal combat, he should still, despite having given him so much in firearms, I should still probably just use a bow since it's reusable. Because I'd hate to run out of ammo when I really need it. Oh. Smell of blood and dead bodies is coming up from the dungeon. No. I don't want to do this. No. I don't want to descend. Okay, prepare to descend. Fine. I'm not going down here yet. I definitely want to look around. Two walls are on top of each other. okay, so that's the way to go to visit a dungeon. Oh, hi. You're one of the tough wargs. These are really not that bad, though. But they're kinda nasty. They will injure me. Right, and they do... ouch. Ah, they do that. What do you think of fire? You don't care too much about it. Ow. Man, these are really quite nasty. The movement pattern is confusing. Whoa, he's hurting a lot. Yow. Oh. Well, that's really inconvenient. You can't use this because... shoot. So the guy who can fix your injury can't cast the injury-fixing spell. Hmm. So I guess you just drink a potion. Fine. That works. Cheaper than visiting the healing crystal, I guess. Alright, so level up. Right, level up is here. I was giving you light weapons, probably. Yeah, okay. So at fifth, I can probably... at fifth skill level, you can dual wield any light weapons. Okay, yeah. I would like that very much. Do I care much about... he has one in fire magic because he's holding this. Oh, yeah, I was giving you sword proficiency. Level 5, any attack with a sword is 20% faster. That's pretty cool. That's a good choice. This is also a good choice. That increases damage. Yeah, no, I think this is a better choice for now. Sure, I'm doing that. Okay. It said something about the bridge when I entered this area. The bridge is out. Got it. Okay. Am I seeing... oh, those are toads. Those are a lot of toads. Oh, boy. Alright, be careful not to fall in the water until I know my way out. My way out is there. Good. That's interesting. Oh, hey. Blueprint. Okay. Completely described steps how enhance longbow with rare mithril iron. You need to find the forging altar and use two mithril, one longbow, and the mithril longbow blueprints. Okay, cool. I don't really have a bow user other than you, so I don't think that's ultimately going to come in too handy. But I have it now. Oh boy, underwater exploration. This is always dicey. I'm kind of more interested in this. What are you? Some sort of just weird plant pod thing. Okay, poison field. I shouldn't have done that. That was silly. Oh well, he'll recover. Seems relatively calm here, other than those nasty wargs that are around somewhere. This goes away eventually. Is that a rock? I think that's a rock. Mm-hmm. If there were something else on the ground, I wouldn't be able to tell, probably. Well, now... okay, I can chop the wood. Oh, hey. Another poison mushroom thing. Now, I shouldn't use arrows on it, because then they get trapped in the poison cloud, so I'll have to come back for that one. Okay, so these things are all over the place, and are kind of annoying. They give me experience, though, so that's cool. Ha! Why? Oh. All right. This has caused herders to come out. Okay, so they get angry when I destroy the mushroom pods. I see. Good to know. Is there one behind me? How did this happen? Ah, really? Alright, let me through. Let me through quick. Go away. Go away. Coming through. People are dying. Everybody's died. Okay, then. Okay, so secretly that's an ambush area. Good to know. I guess I should have assumed there'd be some consequence to destroying those things. But I had no way to know that that would be what it was. Alright, so what did I accomplish? I went there, I killed a couple of wargs, I got some warg steaks. I guess I'll redo that. You know what? Why don't I redo that another day? Okay, well that's what I'm up against. There's some sort of watchtower dungeon in there. Yeah, stuff to fight. Seems cool. I'll come back here next time and explore around and see what awaits me.